हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू उमा देवी चिल्ड्रन एकेडमी स्टूडेंट्स। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द टॉपिक इज एडसॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म। एडसॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म, सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एडसॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म? द एडसॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म मीन्स द एडसॉर्प्शन आर टेक प्लेस ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ एडसॉर्बेंट विद द हेल्प ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर कॉल्ड एडसॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म। स्टूडेंट्स, so let's see under the definition. So amount of gas absorbed by the absorbent with a pressure at the constant temperature can be expressed with the means of adsorption isotherm. Students, so when the gas particles are occupy on the surface of the adsorbent, on the surface of the adsorbent, or you may say any material, then with the help of pressures. With the help of pressure, the gaseous particle are occupy on the surface of the adsorbent called as a adsorption isotherm. So during this adsorption, the temperature remains constant here, in which the temperature remains constant. So that is we called as a adsorption isotherms. Students, so adsorption isotherms, it was discussed the scientist is the Fraenlich adsorption isotherm. Fraenlich, so that's why it is called the Fraenlich adsorption isotherm. So Fraenlich, in the year of 1909, he gave the empirical relationship between the quantity of gas adsorbed by the unit mass of the solid adsorbent and pressure at the particular temperature. So Fraenlich has, in the year of 1909, he given the relationship between the adsorption and the pressure. So that's why he used the x is the adsorbent, m is the adsorbent, and p is the pressure. So he conducted the adsorption he conducted in a different way. The first with the help of low pressure. So X by M means the adsorption. Students, X by M is the adsorption. This is the adsorbate and it is adsorbent. Adsorbate and adsorption. It means the X by M we called as adsorption. Right. So adsorption, X by M means adsorption, is directly proportional to the pressure. As the pressure increases, adsorption on the surface of the adsorbent increases. Right, students? So look at here the graph, students. Right. So here in this, here in y axis I am using the X by M, and here I am using the P. Pressure P. Right, students? So pressure P. So just I am marking here. So students, as the pressure increases here P pressure increases 1 to 2. Right. Then the adsorption also increases here this level. Again pressure increases 3. The adsorption also increases. As the pressure increases 4, adsorption also increases. So it means the adsorption is directly proportional to the pressure. Adsorption is directly proportional to the pressure, because look at here the students, here is this line which is moving on the straight line. Straight form means the adsorptions are increased with respective pressures. As the pressure increases, adsorption also increases. So X by M is proportional to the P. X by M, the K is proportional to constant into P. Right, students? This is the first experiment he conducted, the Fraenlich has conducted. When the pressure increases, then adsorption on the solid surface also increases. He conducted a second experiment at intermediate pressure. इंटरमीडिएट प्रेशर मीन द प्रेशर इज नॉट हाई नॉट लो, इट इज़ अ मॉडरेट प्रेशर्स बिटवीन द इट इज़ रेंज. द मॉडरेट मीन्स इट इज़ बिटवीन द लो एंड हाई, दैट इज इंटरमीडिएट. द प्रेशर बिटवीन द लो एंड हाई दैट इज वी कॉल्ड दिस पोर्शन वी कॉल्ड एज इंटरमीडिएट प्रेशर. एक्स बाय एम डिपेंड अपॉन द पावर ऑफ प्रेशर विच लाइज 0 to 1, दैट इज द फ्रैक्शनल पावर. फ्रैक्शनल पावर, फ्रैक्शनल पावर मीन्स 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.5 एटसेट्रा, राइट. सो लुक एट योर स्टूडेंट्स, सो एज द कंटिन्यूअसली प्रेशर इंक्रीजेस, एज द कंटिन्यूअसली प्रेशर इंक्रीजेस एट अ सर्टेन लेवल, राइट, द एडसॉर्प्शन गोज ऑन डिक्रीजेस. एट द कंटिन्यूअसली प्रेशर गोज ऑन इंक्रीजेस, प्रेशर गोज ऑन इंक्रीजेस कंटिन्यूअसली. सो रैदर देन मूविंग द स्ट्रेट लाइन, रैदर देन मूविंग स्ट्रेट लाइन, द इट इज स्लाइटली बेंड, स्लाइटली बेंड. इट्स बेंडिंग मीन्स द एडसॉर्प्शन गोज ऑन डिक्रीजेस, एडसॉर्प्शन गोज ऑन डिक्रीज. सो एक्स बाय एम इज डिपेंड अपॉन द पावर ऑफ प्रेशर, पावर ऑफ प्रेशर, पावर ऑफ प्रेशर. इट मीन द प्रेशर इज हियर, द एडसॉर्प्शन इज डिक्रीजेस विथ दिस पावर ऑफ प्रेशर. स्टूडेंट्स, सो पावर ऑफ प्रेशर इज टेकन एज ए दैट इज अ पावर, द एक्स बाय एम डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू पी टू द पावर 1/n. वन बाय एन मीन स्टूडेंट्स द 1/n इज द पावर ऑफ प्रेशर. सो हियर द फ्रैक्शनल, इट इज अ फ्रैक्शनल, राइट. एडसॉर्प्शन इंक्रीजेस विद अ फ्रैक्शनल प्रेशर, एडसॉर्प्शन इंक्रीज फ्रैक्शनल प्रेशर. सो इट मीन द फ्रैक्शन प्रेशर इंक्रीज, द फ्रैक्शनल एडसॉर्प्शन इंक्रीज हियर, राइट. द फ्रैक्शन प्रेशर इंक्रीजेस, फ्रैक्शनल एडसॉर्प्शन ऑल्सो increases. It means the adsorption is not so faster, adsorption is the adsorption rate here decreases, students. Adsorption rate here decreases. Right, students? So next is the high pressure. When high pressure, so at the high pressure the graph becomes, the adsorption becomes the independent of pressure. It means the adsorption cannot be depend upon the pressure. The first case, at low pressure adsorption completely depend upon pressure. The pressure increases, adsorption increases, right. So here at the pressure slightly increases, slightly adsorption increases. But then the third case, last case, adsorption is cannot be depend upon the pressure. Adsorption cannot be depend upon pressure, right. When you are continuously increasing the adsorption at a certain stage, the adsorption remains constant here. Adsorption remains constant in this level, adsorptions are constant. You are continuously passing the gas particles over a surface of solids, then the gaseous particles in which the saturation attain. It means, students, when here some gas particles are present, so look at here, the some gaseous particles are present here, four gas particles. I will give example. Here the four gas particle A, two particles are present here, right. So when the another B gas particles are, we are applying the pressure, then B gas particles are came, then what happens, students? The one A is removed, at that place one B is added. Similarly, if you are adding the two, as you are passing the two B molecules, two A particles are departed from the place, at that place the two B particles are attacked. It means the saturations are attained here. Saturation means, students, the last time we have discussed the saturation solutions, saturation in the solution chapter. Similarly, if the here 100 gas particles are present here, 100 gas particles. So if you are passing the another gas P1, we are passing the another gas P1, right. If the P1 gas passed, then what happened? The 100 out of 1 G gas is removed, at that place the 1 P is occupying. So if you are passing the 2 P gas, then the two gas particles are departed from the place, at that place the 2P added here. If you are passing the 20P particle, the 20P particles are removed from here. So it means the surface in which the adsorption particles are departed their place. The how many particles are departed? If the one adsorbed particles are removed at their place, the one B particles are occupied, right? If the two A particles are removed, they departed from the place, at their place two B particles are occupied. It means the adsorptions are remained constant here. Adsorption remain constant, so that is we called as the adsorption is cannot be depend upon the pressure, right? That explained by the Fraunlich. Students, it means the adsorption at when we are applying the pressure over surface of the adsorption, and the adsorption initially adsorption depend upon pressure. A pressure increase, adsorption increase. But when we are pressure is moderate, when pressure moderate, the adsorption is slightly depend upon pressure. In the final case, when the all the surface, the solid surface completely occupied the gas particles. Solid surface completely occupied the gas particle, then you apply the pressure, then there is no adsorption occurs. No adsorption occurs with the help of pressure. That is we called as the adsorption at high pressure. Look at here, students, I will give you this example. So here the A particles are present here. A particles. If you are adding the B, then what happens, students? A B. One A is removed here. So look at here, students. Here three particles, 1, 2, 3. Here also 1, 2, 3. Right? It means the three particles on the solid surface of the adsorbent. When we add the one more gas particle, the space, the one A particle is departed, at that place new particles are occupying. So it means the pressure cannot be affected if the solid surface are completely occupied by the gaseous particles. Right, students? So look at here, students. Here the pressure is constant at the adsorption 273 Kelvin. Adsorption is constant at the pressure constant at the constant temperature. The adsorption is this much. Again, temperature increases, the adsorption is increased here. Again, temperature increase, adsorption also increases. Students, it means at the constant temperature, temperature remains constant here. If we are using the temperature constant, it means the as the temperature decreases, temperature decreases means pressure increases. If temperature decreases, the pressure increases as the temperature to 273 Kelvin, the adsorption is very less. And 243 adsorption is increases. Again, temperature decrease, adsorptions are again increases here. Right, students? So adsorption isotherm. So x is the mass of the gas adsorbed by the mass of the adsorbent at the pressure p, at the constant. In case k and n are the constant, the nature of the adsorbent and the gas particular temperature. So k and n, the proportion is constant. K pressure p, k and n constant, which is depend upon the nature of the adsorbent and the gas. Already we have discussed, students, the nature of adsorbent. So nature of the adsorbent is remain same, it is universal, but the gas plays the most important role. So the more is a liquefiable gas, SO2 is more easily adsorbed than methane is more easily adsorbed than H2, right? So the adsorption is depend upon the gas. The adsorbent is remain same for all gas, all substances. So relationship is represented by the curve, where the mass of the gas adsorbed by the per gram adsorbent plotted against pressure. The curve is the fixed pressure. The curve at what are the curves are indicated here. This is the fixed pressure in the decrease in physical adsorption with increased temperature. So as the temperature increases, adsorptions are decreases. As the temperature increase, adsorptions are decreased, students. Right, students? So the curve always approaches to the saturation at high pressure. So this is the saturation at 273 Kelvin. This is the saturation pressure, saturation adsorption. At the pressure the at the temperature 244 this is the saturation adsorption. At the temperature 195 this is saturation of adsorption. Students, so the Fraenlich adsorption isotherm verified by plotting the verified by plotting graph with the we are plot the graph by applying log here, log x by m on the y axis, log p on the x axis. Then the it comes to the straight line, the Fraenlich adsorption, the Fraenlich adsorption. Excellent. The figure 5.2, the 1 by n, the interception of y axis is gives the log value of log k. Excellent. So and the 1 by n between the 0 and 1, it gives the is good over the limited at range of pressure. Range of pressure. So 1 by n value range of pressure. So all these things we will discuss here, students. So when we apply the log to find out the k value, to find out the k value, we have to put the log both side, log adsorption and log pressure. Then we got the adsorption here, log k value we got here. So this is the adsorption isotherm graph, students. And when 1 by n is 0, x by n is constant. When 1 by n, it means the intermediate pressure. The intermediate pressure is partial. Intermediate pressure is partial. Then x by m is constant. The adsorption is independent of the pressure. X by n constant means there is no adsorption. X by m means no adsorption. No adsorption. No adsorption. Students. So the adsorption varies directly with the pressure. So adsorption is the changes with respect to pressure. At high pressure, it is attain the saturation. At low pressure, slowly increases. Intermediate pressure, the saturation decreases. So conditions always supported by the experimental result. So what are the conditions are there? The conditions are at low pressure, high pressure, and the intermediate pressure. So intermediate pressure. So these are the conditions. So experimental isotherm always seem to be approach the saturation at high pressure. Saturation attained at a high pressure. This cannot be explained by the Fraenlich isotherm. Thus it fails at high pressure. So Fraenlich adsorption is fails. The Fraenlich adsorption has failed because it cannot explain the high pressure. About the high pressure. So this is about the Fraenlich adsorption theory, students. Then again he using the x by m is proportional to the k to the power 1 by n. N is greater than 1. N is the greater than 1, students, greater than 1. So adsorptions is proportional to the intermediate pressure. At intermediate pressure the 1 by n means the intermediate pressure, the partial pressure or less pressure. So less adsorptions are occurs here. Yes, students.